With major kudos to Dr. Stephen Buchanan, he has developed the ability to produce three-dimensional replicas of teeth both internally and externally, giving us the potential to observe the functionality of endodontic instruments to cleanse highly oval, isthmus-like anatomy while conserving tooth structure in the far thinner mesiodistal plane. We first gain access to the pulp chamber in the traditional manner, here using a number 4 surgical length high-speed round bar. Our explorer confirms that we have gained access to the distal root. From the occlusal, we can see that the pulpal configuration is highly oval, wide in the buccolingual plane, and much thinner in the mesiodistal plane. It should be noted that the pulpal anatomy mirrors the external anatomy of the root. The distal pulp space is somewhat C-shaped, reflecting the concavity present on the furcal side of the root, further emphasizing the thin mesiodistal width. The next step is to irrigate the pulp chamber, introducing a reservoir of irrigant, 17% EDTA or 6% sodium hypochlorite. That will lubricate and disinfect the canal as we manually negotiate an 06-tipped, 02-tapered stainless steel SafeSider to the apex. Please note that modified reamers are far more efficient than the traditional use of K-files because they encounter far less resistance along length while shaving dentin away more efficiently, particularly in the buccolingual plane. Once the 06-tip SafeSider is negotiated to the apex manually and the proper length determined, it is transferred to the 40 to 45 degree reciprocating handpiece, oscillating at 3,000 to 4,000 cycles per minute for rapid and effective shaping in the all-important buccolingual plane. With an arc of motion limited to 40 to 45 degrees, or 7 minutes on the face of a clock, the instruments are virtually free of breakage. Consequently, the dentist has the freedom to work the vertically oriented blades of the SafeSiders vigorously against the wider buccolingual diameter of the canal. Oscillating at 3,000 to 4,000 cycles per minute, the modified reamers efficiently remove dentin in the buccolingual plane, widening what is often a non-negotiable isthmus when using greater tapered rotary instruments. As you can see, widening the canal buccolingually sequentially allows each slightly wider instrument to faithfully follow the glide path that is being ever more defined with each previous instrument. We are also creating a wider space that allows irrigation to become increasingly effective, allowing the sodium hypochlorite to digest more and more of the remaining pulp tissue. Please note that we are always emphasizing the shaping done in the buccolingual plane. That is because buccal and lingual extensions of tissue are present that must be removed to effectively cleanse the canals. The far thinner mesiodistal plane will take care of itself if the wider buccolingual plane is properly prepared. Once the canal is properly widened in both planes with the 2002 modified SafeSider in the 40 to 45 degree reciprocating handpiece, we are ready to switch to the 2 Tango instruments that have the ability to cut more aggressively in the buccolingual plane, again without fear of instrument separation. The Tango-Endo instruments consist of a shaper and a finisher and are used in a latch type 45 degree reciprocating handpiece oscillating at 3,000 to 4,000 cycles per minute. As noted by the obvious slurry they create, they are designed to be more aggressive in removing dentin in the buccolingual plane. Again, without fear of instrument separation, they too are vigorously applied to the buccal and lingual walls. One might ask why we have 2 different reciprocating handpieces. Here is the reason. The SafeSiders are made mostly from twisted stainless steel and are highly resistant to breakage even when overly rotated. They can be used safely both manually and in the reciprocating handpiece. The Tango Endo instruments are made from machined stainless steel and nitai, and if overly rotated, are subject to breakage. By confining their use to a latch type 45 degree reciprocating handpiece, they cannot be overly rotated and will remain intact. This is crucial for the dentist to have confidence in the system and used in the recommended fashion. The result is a canal tapered in 2 planes, but the taper is not one producing a conical shape, something routinely and inappropriately created when using greater tapered rotary nitai. The Tango Endo instruments produce a larger version of the original canal shape, creating a larger taper in the buccolingual plane where the root is wide and a minimum taper in the mesiodistal plane where the root is thin, more accurately reflecting the original anatomy of the pulpal space. This is clearly seen in the occlusal views of the canal preparation, where the buccolingual preparation is far wider than the mesiodistal preparation, reflecting the original canal anatomy in larger form. Canals shaped to a 30-04 are wide enough mesiodistally to allow the placement of the 25-04 tango-endo gutta-percha points accurately and with tugback. Obviously, there is a lot of lateral space that must be filled to fully occlude the prepared canals. I am not interested in optimizing the amount of gutta-percha in the canal via thermoplastic techniques that shrink while cooling to body temperature, nor am I interested in placing excessive stress on the prepared roots by the application of strong vertical and lateral condensation. What I am interested in is occluding the entire space using an epoxy resin cement that has excellent dimensional stability, bonds to both the dentin and gutta-percha, and is highly resistant to hydrolytic degradation. The gutta-percha point is simply an accurate carrier and driver of the cement that is doing the actual sealing of the canal space. We use the bidirectional spiral as a cement applicator. It is used approximately 4 millimeters short of the apex, as well as more coronally, where a common space between the canals exists. The spiral is loaded with cement as shown, and using an up and down motion applied to the walls of the canal in the common, more coronal area, as well as the two independent canal pathways. After flooding the canal space with cement, each of the two pre-fitted points is liberally coated with cement and reintroduced into the canal, fully filling the canal space with a combination of cement and gutta-percha. Please note how we were able to fully shape and then obturate a highly oval isthmus-like anatomy. This is an impossible task with rotary knife tie. Even if the instruments were able to extend their preparation to the buccolingual plane, they would be removing too much tooth structure in the mesiodistal plane. The combination of the SafeSider glide path through a 20 and the two Tango-Endo instruments accomplished this task while preserving dentin in the mesiodistal plane, producing what would have been thought of as incompatible goals: thorough cleansing and the preservation of tooth structure. The thinness of the root on its furcal side clearly tells us that conservation of tooth structure is a primary goal.